Hello everyone, welcome to another video on my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to discuss about food delivery chatbots. So recently I got an opportunity to build a food delivery chatbot. So the owner of this website contacted me through Fiverr. I have a Fiverr seller profile where I sell Dialogflow chatbots. So he contacted me and we discussed the possibilities of food delivery chatbot, and I built one for that person. So let's see how they handle food order on their website. So basically what I have done is replicated the same process on chatbot. So basically what they do, they first select a category, let's say Mexican food, and after that they select item. Now in that item they have to select variant of different add-ons like meat choices, taco modifier, choose extra chile and everything. So they select items from this variants or add-ons and then they place the order or add that food item into their cart. So let's see how it works on the chatbot. Let's first start the chatbot by saying hello. Now one important thing here is that the text is not formatted properly because this is on a simulator, but if we connect the chatbot to WhatsApp or Facebook Messenger, it will have formatted text. Also it can have rich responses like buttons, images, everything. So I thought I should let you know about that. You can say order food. It gave empty response because the webhook is deployed on Heroku on a free tier. So it doesn't leave always, but when we invoke it, it starts. So hopefully this time it will work. Let's say menu. So okay, so it works. So it shows different categories. Let's say Mexican food. So again, as I told you, the text is not properly formatted. Let's say taco. So the first thing is choose a meat choice. Let's say chicken. Okay, let's choose a taco modifier. Let's say with everything. Let's say regular tortilla. Let's say no extra chile. Let's say extra lime. Let's say two quantity. Now it asks if you want to add another item to the cart. If you say yes, then it will loop over the same process, shows the category. You choose category, select item, select all the variants. If you say no here, it will show you the summary of your cart. Also, it will have all the variants you have chosen for that particular menu item. Also, it says that do you want to remove any item from the cart? So let's say yes, I want to remove item from a cart. So it will show the items currently in your cart, and let's say you say please remove taco, then it will remove taco from your cart, and it now says since our cart is empty, it says your cart is empty, please select a category to move forward. So this is the flow of the food delivery chatbot. Also, one important thing is that after, you know, when you are satisfied with the items in your cart, you provide your name, email, mobile number, and delivery or pickup information, and it will do the rest things. One important thing is that I have created entities for all the things, like for categories, food items, variants. So you know, it catches everything very smoothly. Let's say if we say instead of Mexican food, we'll like say Mexican only. It also catches that, and you can see the category is Mexican food. Okay, so this is it. I hope you like the video, and if you have any questions, you can ask the question in the comment section. If you want to know more about this chatbot and back end of this chatbot, you can contact me. Another important thing is that I have done this with the help of API. So every response is coming from API. So I hope this gives some information on this food delivery chatbots. See you in the next video. Peace.